Hi, I'm Rachel Boyd of In the Grow.
I'm Vikram Baliga with the Department of Plant and Soil Science at Texas Tech.
So today we're gonna watch some plant videos and react.
That's actually like a bonsai technique.
Okay.
What they did with the pine cones. So they'll take pine cones and I don't actually know the whole process for it, right? But they'll plant pine cones and germinate the trees in the pine cone and make it look like a little pine forest. And so that one actually is cool and works. But this next one, I'm excited about this next one. Okay.
Oh, look how sad all this.
They so
look
many
sad,
questions.
Don't they?
One,
I think they look sad.
One, that keyboard worked.
Yeah.
And
way to waste.
So why
electronics.
Do you hate your keyboard?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't understand why the keyboard hate.
No comprende.
So two, if you're gonna use your keyboard to start microgreens, why put the keys back in?
Yeah.
Okay. And then my biggest question watching some of these is now what?
Yeah.
What's your end game? Right?
Like, you're just forcing the plant to do all this extra strain and work to get around the keys. And why can't you just use a pot? Or outside?
Pretty much anything but a keyboard. Unless you are throwing a Halloween party where your home is supposed to have been taken over by nature.
Yeah.
Even then.
Yeah. You should only use this for, like, a prop in, like, a Little Shop of Horrors production.
Yeah. I can think of absolute like zero. There's literally no practical. I don't like this.
And even if you were gonna do a production of Little Shop of Horrors, I think you could do a better job with like some pothos and some things that wouldn't be hurt by growing out of like random.
I mean,
electronics.
You know, y'all, you can ruin literally anything. If you want to bad enough, you can put plants in it and break it. You know.
This is just for people who are like chaotic evil.